Here's a question. Can a 3D printed part like this actually hold up a car? Specifically a Tesla? Well, today we're going to find out. This video is sponsored by PCBWay. Hello, 3D printing friends, and welcome back. Tesla owners need these little things called jack pads. They fit into a recess on the underside of the car, so when you lift it up with a jack, you don't damage the battery or the frame. Now, you can buy a set of these on Amazon for about 20 bucks. But here's the problem. Different Tesla models can have slightly different hole sizes. That means you could buy a set that fits too loosely, or one that's so tight it's a pain to pull back out. So I designed my own jack pad in Tinkercad, and instead of using a hard plastic like PLA or PETG, I decided to go with TPU. Why TPU? Well, it's flexible, and it's grippy, and it has enough strength to handle some serious weight. Plus, a spool costs about the same as a set of pads online, maybe a few bucks more. But once you've got it, you can print as many custom pads as you want. In fact, I printed all of these from this one spool of TPU, and there's still a lot of filament left. So I printed these on the Elegoo Centauri Carbon, which is a printer I really like. Flexible filaments like TPU can sometimes be difficult to print, but the Centauri Carbon handles TPU really well. I bought this spool of Overture Neon Orange TPU on Amazon to do these tests because I've used Overture TPU in the past and it always prints well. And also because I figured orange would be a good standout color, making it harder to lose one of these things. And when you're printing TPU, it's a good idea to use some kind of interface layer between the bed and the print. A glue stick works fine, but I really like Vision Miner's nanopolymer adhesive. It keeps the print stuck to the bed during the print job and protects the bed from being damaged by TPU sticking too well when it's time to remove the finished print. So using Elegoo Slicer, I set the filament type to Elegoo TPU, and then I adjusted some of the strength settings. I set the number of walls to 8, and I set the top and bottom to be 1 millimeter thick. And then I sliced and printed the jack pad with different infill amounts. 25%, 50%, 75%, and one at 90% just to get close to solid. The 25% infill jack pad took about 4 hours to print. The 50% one took about 5.5 hours to print. The 75% infill jack pad took almost 7 hours to print. And finally, the 90% one took just under 8 hours, clocking in at 7 hours, 45 minutes. And looking at these, you can see the Centauri Carbon just did an amazing job printing them. The surface finish is smooth and glossy, and the layers are all neatly stacked. There's a bit of stringing inside the nub at the top, but that's not a big deal on this particular part. That kind of thing can be removed with needle nose pliers or a heat gun if it bugs you. PCBWay is known for making low-cost, high-quality printed circuit boards, but they also do CNC machining, 3D printing, sheet metal fabrication, and even injection molding. They sent me a few samples, and I gotta say, these circuit board rulers and coasters are freaking amazing. And the clear resin prints of the PCBWay logo, these are 100% crystal clear. So whether you need PCBs, machining services, or even something printed in a specialty material your printer can't handle, PCBWay can do that for you. Check them out at PCBWay.com. Okay, so it's prediction time, and here's what I think will happen. The 25% pad is going to get squished. The 50% pad might survive, but it's iffy. The 75% and 90% ones, I think those will hold the weight. But what do you think? Pause the video and drop your guess in the comments before we start testing. So let's head out to the garage and see what happens when we start trying to lift the car with these jack pads. Okay, here we go with the 25% infill jack pad. Yeah, that one's basically useless. The car is crushing it, in a bad way. At least TPU parts go back to their original shape when the pressure's off. Okay, now let's see how the 50% infill jack pad performs. This one's doing better, but you can see it's still deforming. I wouldn't necessarily trust it long term. Let's get that one out of there. And now the 75% infill jack pad. Let's see what it does. All right, now we're talking. This one holds its shape with just a little bit of squish, and it does the job. The wheel is off the ground. Let's set this back down and move on to the next one. And finally, the 90% infill jack pad. So this pad, it's nearly solid. The wheel is off the ground again, and it's handling the weight without even breaking a sweat. Okay, time to set the car back on the ground again and head back up to the studio. Okay, the testing was fun, but it's kind of hot out there, so I'm happy to be back inside. And here are the results. 25% is a squishy failure. Like, it didn't break, but it also didn't look like it was up to the task at all. 50% is okay-ish, but still squishy-esque. It was a bit skewed, and I didn't feel like I wanted to put the whole weight of the car on it. And 75% and 90% both work really well. Did I get that right? Yeah. They were able to support the weight of the car with minimal squish, with the 90% infill one exhibiting the least amount of squish, as expected. So, despite the poor results from lower amounts of infill, TPU can absolutely handle the job. And since you can design these yourself, you can tweak the fit for your specific Tesla model. That's something you can't always guarantee if you just buy a random set online. So, can a 3D print hold up a Tesla? Yes, absolutely. Just don't do it at 25% infill. If you found this experiment fun, give the video a thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't already, and let me know in the comments what else you might like to see 3D printed and tested. Thanks again to PCBWay for sponsoring this episode, thank you for watching, and big thanks to everyone who supports the channel, whether with channel memberships or by using the links in the description. Well, 3D printing friends, that's about all the time we have for this one, and now that we're at the end, let's go print something cool.